few years back, my family went to Universal for Christmas. It was around that time that they just opened up their new replica of Willy Wonka's Chocolate Factory, and my friend and I both wanted to go. Neither of us were loaded enough to stay at the resort inside the park, but we were able to get rooms in the same cheaper hotel just a few miles away. As tainted as my memory of that weekend is, I clearly recall that the day we spent roaming through the park together was a blast. Everything was festively decorated and covered in snow, a big deal for Florida boys. After a long day of walking through the park and visiting all the attractions, pigging out on various chocolatey culinary concoctions at the chocolate factory, and coercing our parents into buying a bunch of gifts, the sun was setting on our Christmas vacation. However, we still had one more night at the hotel. Our parents had planned this in advance and had gotten a little too drunk to drive all the way home. While our parents were passed out in bed, my friend and I couldn't sleep. Our minds were buzzing with all the things we'd done that day, and we didn't want it to end just yet. We were dueling each other on a mobile game when he messaged me. "Yo, I saw a gym on the way up. You want to race on the treadmills?" My feet were still sore from all the walking, but it seemed like a good way to blow off some steam. Sure, but...
Late at night? Okay.
"Don't worry about it. I'll use my room key. Just meet me on my floor." That meant I'd have to sneak out and go downstairs, but that wouldn't be hard. My parents were out cold. The only trouble I had was finding where they put the room key so I could get back in unnoticed. It took several tense minutes of digging through my mother's purse in the dark, but I finally found it. I carefully opened the door and slipped out, heading quickly for the elevator. I only got a few steps in before I heard somebody walking behind me. I stopped and turned around, and immediately got stranger danger vibes. There was a man standing in the hallway, half dressed as Santa Claus. And by that, I mean he was half naked. All he had on were the boots, the fake beard, and a stocking cap, along with the most strained pair of stained briefs I've ever seen. Other than that, he carried a flimsy red sack that didn't look very full at all. I immediately spun back around and started power walking to the elevator. I heard him shuffling behind me, trying to catch up. When I got to the elevator, I spammed the down arrow. I knew that wouldn't make it go any faster, but my panicked brain was willing to try anything. By the time the doors finally opened, I could feel the creep right behind me, breathing down my neck.
"Well, aren't you going in?"
"You can go first."
"No problem, my little angel."
I stepped aside and let him through. As he boarded the elevator, he sang,
"All I want for Christmas is you."
Then he retrieved something from his limp sack and stretched his arm through the doorway, holding out an unwrapped candy cane. There was a bunch of red lint from the sack stuck onto it, but not wanting to aggravate him for any reason, I took it without any intention of eating it. Finally, he dropped his arm and cleared the doorway. We stared at each other for a few unbearable seconds, until at last the door slid closed and I was freed from his gaze. I didn't see him push any buttons, so I was worried he would open the doors and reappear at any second. To make sure I didn't run into him again, I took the stairs down to my friend's floor. But, of course, my woes were not done for the night. The first thing I saw when I opened the door into the hallway was my friend having a seizure. I dropped the candy cane and rushed to him, calling out for help.
"Help! Help! Somebody call the cops! Help!"
My friend was frothing at the mouth, his eyes pure white from rolling back into his head, thrashing violently despite all my attempts to calm him down. There was nothing I could do. It wasn't until he'd already gone limp and unresponsive that people finally emerged from their rooms to see what was going on. I'm no doctor, but I knew at that point he was already dead. Nobody ever talks about how people empty their bowels and bladder in their moment of death. I'm not a detective either, but I had a pretty good idea as to what had killed him. Clutched in his dying grip was the same kind of dusty, unwrapped candy cane that the half-naked Santa had given me. In the following months, I was subpoenaed to testify against that worthless turd of a man. And during my appearances in the court, I got to learn far more than I wanted to. The hotel security cameras had ample footage of the man stalking multiple people in the hallways and trying to offer them his candy canes, which he laced with some kind of extremely potent poison. No matter how many times he raved about it, I'll never understand his delusional motive. Something about bringing people closer together for Christmas by sending them all to heaven. I don't even care anymore.
It's dark. But the heaven part, not so much, but just forcing them to die. Oh my God.
I hope my friend's parents get a fortune from that hotel for their negligence. Letting a man like that roam around their hallways during the holiday.
Oh, really?